Hey everyone, so it's Tiff, and today I am here to give you some more business strategies for the month. Every month I'll be doing one business strategy, and today's business strategy is very short, so to add to the video, you know, to give you some extra knowledge, whatever, I'm gonna do a business strategy and important information about, you know, bookkeeping. Something that I really, really, really recommend that you do. Well, not recommend, like you must do it, you know, or must have it done if you're running a business. Okay, so let me cut off this music to get started with the vending machine business and look at my notes. Okay, so basically with a vending machine business, your profit margin for the month could be, you know, about $3,000, which is pretty good. Now, you wonder, like, where can you buy a vending machine? I suggest that you Google it. But I heard that you could buy a used vending machine for, like, $850 or $900. After you get the vending machine, you buy your snacks or whatever you want to put in there. You could go to a warehouse and get, like, bulk items or snacks. I seen a vending machine on Instagram of somebody, like they had a whole vending machine of eyelashes. Like you could get creative with these things. You don't have to just stick to sodas, foods, and snacks, but it's very popular, you know, especially like in areas where it's high traffic, like a mall or traveling or college, whatever. Now, after you get the snacks and the vending machine and stuff, the next thing you do, well, I don't know what order you could do it in, whatever you choose, whatever feels comfortable to you. You could pick a location that you're going to put it in. Now, the location I researched online might charge you like $50 a month, or they might charge you 15% or higher than that, you know, depending on your sales. And I also heard that some locations will let you put your machine, you know, in a spot for free if you have like a donation sticker on it. And I think for the donation sticker, you probably have to pay the charity like $1 a month or something, you know. But whatever I'm telling you, please go do your research. Google is a free tool for all. What else with this vending machine business? When I was in Disney, they had vending machines that had like detergents and fabric softeners and stuff like that. So you could be very creative with this. Now, please keep in mind that if someone do allow you to put your machine in there, the vending machines do take electricity, and the establishment do have to pay for that electricity. So, you know, like, don't try to always get things for free. But if they do free, then that's cool. That's cool for both of you, you know. So, let me see if I can wrap this up. Use integrity. I have vending machines that stole my money. So, have good customer service, you know. And that's about it. That's all I could think of. Okay, so now about the bookkeeping thing. The last couple of days, I've been doing bookkeeping. I'm catching up, you know, with my bookkeeping and stuff like that. And I just want to tell y'all the things that you will have to pay for in a business and the things you will have to pay attention to in a business. Now, you know, I'm not sure how you're going to word it inside your, you know, accounting log or your bookkeeping. I'm using Excel. You know, I'm using Microsoft Excel for it, and I love it. I used to use, like, a paid service, and I just was, like, everywhere, so I don't use it anymore, and I paid my sister. She's a certified accountant, you know, a lot of money to do my bookkeeping for me, and I lost all the records because I no longer have that service, so I'm doing it myself. But you could also hire you a bookkeeper for, like, about $150 to $200 a month, you know, a real person, plus they have services online that will do it for you. So this is the things that I wrote in my bookkeeping thing. Like, what I'm paying attention to is my expenses, because I want to know how much I make. A lot of people online, they will tell you how much they make, But at the end of the day, most people don't say how much they profited. And a way to find out how much you profited, you could either do daily profits or you could do your monthly profits. All you gotta do is calculate your expenses all together, all the expenses that you incur that's business related, even when it comes to like paying your no, not including paying yourself, you know, because you could pay yourself zero, you know, but you wanna calculate all the expenses. And then you want to calculate all the revenue. Revenue is the amount that you made in sales. So if I sold a pair of shoes for $60, my revenue was $60 for that day. You know, if all my sales came out to $10,000 that month, that was my revenue for that month. But that doesn't mean that's how much I brought home because I have expenses. Your expenses could be 50% of that. So let's say if I made 10,000, that means I really made 5,000 if I calculate all the expenses out. Some people make 30% profit or 20% profit, which is less than 5,000. So, you know, unless you like have an agency or something and you're selling digital products, then you have a higher profit margin, you know? So basically, this is the type of expenses that I have. That I wrote into my Excel sheet. Okay, so I'm gonna list all my expenses. I wrote down the refunds. Last month I had one refund. My marketing expense. Last month I only did email marketing. I didn't do Facebook ads. I didn't do Instagram ads or nothing. So that was pretty good and that really helped my profit margin. I'm shocked that, you know, the amount of money that I made from just email marketing, but it's possible. Organic traffic is great. So we got refunds, we got marketing expenses, we got loan repayments if you're paying loans. Shopify offer capital loans if your store is doing pretty good. So you could use the that loan to grow your business and you know the buy things, you know, to better promote yourself, whatever, to help grow your brand. So that's pretty good and you could pay like 20 or 30% per each sale back. You know, they just deduct the money every day from you. They lend like 5, 10, 20 thousands of dollars on Shopify. That's why I highly recommend it. And please, you know, sign up for my classes and everything. You can visit my website, manifestmybusiness.com. So we got. I'm doing a Shopify class and I'm gonna be doing a drop shipping class and stuff like that. But let me get back on topic. Refunds, marketing, loan repayments, your product, your products. So that's an expense too. Like if you bought your products, you gotta add in how much you paid for them. If you drop ship, you know, you gotta add them in, you know, each product daily, just add it all up. Your PayPal transaction fees, your Shopify transaction fees, that's the fees that I have because that's the two payment options. And I just realized how much I'm paying in fees. Man, travel expenses, you could have a write-off for travel expenses if your business includes traveling. Your phone and internet and electric. Now, you can't do 100% of that. You could do a certain percentage of how much you use a month. And your application fees if you pay for paid apps on Shopify. Your postal fees if you ship your own products. And miscellaneous expenses. Miscellaneous, I put like all my random stuff in there. I sort of got to tweak it because I even have advertising materials in there. And that could be a whole separate thing. But I have GoDaddy.com, you know, I have my equipment, you know, like assets, my domain name, my email host, because I pay like a monthly fee just for my emails. And with all these other websites, I'm debating if I'm just gonna, you know, buy me another one, which I have to, because it's professional. You have to do it. I'm just being cheap. And then yearly, I have like a Shopify fee. Because I'm paying like a yearly rate instead of the monthly. And then I have the revenue. So I add up all those expenses together, you know, and in a row, like all the refunds, all the marketing and everything that came out of my account, all those got added together. All of them also had like their own chart listing, and then at the bottom, you know, of each listing, I had like the total and added them together, and then I subtracted it by the revenue. The revenue is how much I made per month. I wrote down all my sales per day, like per 30 days, and I added that together, and I got my revenue for the month. On Shopify, you could also like just put how much you made for the month, and it will show you. You know, but I really, you know, got specific and wrote everything down. And then that's how much you find out that you profited. Some people might be losing money and don't even notice. You might be making $20,000 a month and your expenses might be like $15,000, and then you overpaying yourself. And then you might have like, you know, savings in the bank, and then you wondering like, what the heck? Why every month I can't save nothing? When you do bookkeeping, you know where your money is going. That's a lesson that, you know, I knew. That, you know, I was just so overwhelmed and I didn't do it. So now I'm like doing a whole bunch of backed up work. Backed up, you know, taxes and bookkeeping. So don't be like me when it comes to that. Do your bookkeeping, do your taxes, and do it daily if you can, because I don't want to pay nobody, so I'm doing my own stuff. I paid my sister last year, and I lost all the records, so now I'm putting it into my own computer, because she uploaded it to, you know, the program I was using, and she didn't really complete it, because she didn't do anything from the PayPal, because I never gave it to her. So, I paid for a service that I didn't even use, you know. Don't waste money running a business, you know. That's about it. I think I covered everything. It was something else. Oh, yeah. So, if you want to sign up for Shopify, please click the link in my description. I need you to subscribe. Because every month I'll be giving away some, I'll be dropping some jewels every month. I'll be giving away a business strategy for a year. I'm not sure how long I want to be doing this. Randomly, I might, you know, post some other videos. You can follow me on Instagram. I'll be having like, you know, educational stuff related to business and e-commerce on my Instagram page. It's Manifest My Brand. And visit my website, manifestmybusiness.com. But please subscribe, show me some love. Make sure you comment on my Instagram page, the you know, the hike up my algorithm. Did I say that right? Tag some friends, refer them to my page. When my classes start, I might have an affiliate program where you might get a percentage from referring people to take my classes and stuff like that. So, I'm still hooking it up. You can check on my website to see if my Shopify class is available, where I'll be going live on a webinar, help you set it up, and a whole nine, and send you the links and everything. You have to click my link, you know. And I will be having a dropship course and Instagram and celebrity course. The Instagram course is not building followers. It's a whole nother story. And it's basically how to make money on it. And how to, you know, how I got celebrities, you know, to wear my stuff. And I didn't get them on Instagram, so it has nothing to do with Instagram. But I combined the two together. I might separate it. I don't know. But thank you for watching. And happy holidays, everybody. I'm not sure when I'm going to be on here again. Like, I'm not sure if I'm going to be on here before New Year's, but I know for a fact I'll post another video after New Year's on another business strategy. And one more thing. Check my links below. I have a Patreon account. So, sign up for my Patreon. Sign up for everything. Whatever you see in that link description below, click on it. Sign up for it. And stay in touch. And I forgot to announce my little resume in the beginning of this video. For those who's new that's watching this, I'm the designer of Kingdom of Mel. I had made six figures with this business. I had multiple celebrities rock my brand. I had thousands of customers worldwide. My brand website is kingdomofmel.com. My Instagram is at kingdom_of_mel, Mel. And my Facebook is Kingdom of Mel. Facebook, I have about 60K followers, and Instagram, I have about 55K followers. So, if you go to my little Instagram page for Manifest My Brand and you see the little followers, I just made that account. Check the date on this video. I just made that account. So I'm building it up from scratch. I'm doing something that I actually like doing, helping others. And I just want to tell y'all what I did to get where I was at, when it came to entrepreneurship and business. But anyways, this video is getting long as heck. I'm gonna get off of here. You have a wonderful day.